Hey everybody, please don't tell me that summer is almost over. We've got, I see some children in the audience, so that's nice to know that there are some people who are not in school yet. Thank you for joining us here at Live Lunch Break. My name is Peter Huapi from The Day, and welcome to what may be our last Live Lunch Break of the summer. We are very fortunate to have, now I know there's some argument about this, but possibly the only Brit Americana band in the world. Certainly in this area. So please join me in welcoming Monkey68.
Hey, ready again?
We'll sit on the side. I want to swim with sharks and blame them when they bite. I want the media to tell me what I mean. Don't want to think too hard, that's my opinion. I want the government to keep my brain off screen, to take it easily. Responsibility is just a frame of mind, and I'm not taking mine. Too busy burning up in too much sunshine. Have you ever
let them steal. Thank you.
This song goes like side by side. And there's a place you can find in the sky where you and I can stand side by side. Head to head, toe to toe. Tomorrow just ain't no place to go when you're living for today. There's a thing between your ears and your eyes. If you use it, then you soon realize.
Here and good to see a lot of you out there enjoying the sandwiches from Parade Cafe and the drinks from Hygienic Art. So Vince, on the web you described the genre of Monkey 68 as Brit Americana.
Yeah.
And we sort of referenced that in the intro, but it got me to wondering, so that's a nod to your heritage. So growing up in England, did you feel like you were subject to different musical influences because of geography, or do we just live in a world now where pop music is so international that geography doesn't really matter?
I think it was becoming more geographical as I was growing up, but you know, I was born in 68, which is where the name comes from, and so I grew up with the third generation of songwriters post rock and roll. So if you think about the Beatles, the Who, then what was happening in the punk explosion in the 70s, I was like 8 years old during the punk thing, which is great because I loved it. And then by the time I was writing songs, it moved on to the early 80s and what was happening with indie rock then. So to me, it's all like this big funnel of distillation that comes down to, some of it sounds British, it sounds like The Who, it sounds like The Beatles, it sounds like whatever it sounds like. But some of it's, like the last one, is just dead on Americana. I mean, it's like there's no British band that sang a song like I just sang, I guess. I don't think so, anyway.
So, I know you, and I think a lot of people know you as a solo acoustic performer. You've got a bunch of albums out under the name Vince Tuckwood. Do you write any... So, talk about the material that you're playing in the band context versus what you play solo. Do you write differently for the band versus solo?
I think it's arranged differently. We work stuff as a band to be different. I record Unamarried Name just because I was out on the Vince Tucker singing, so people knew that name. But I've always recorded in a home as Monkey 68. So this is an extension of that with two other very capable monkeys who actually can do better than me on the instruments that I bluff in the studio. In terms of writing, none of those first three, the first three songs haven't been on a solo record. The fourth one was, it was on Sparse, but that was just acoustic, so this is different when we do it as a band. So they're interchangeable. But my plan would be that the next solo record will be more like Sparse, more acoustic, and we'll do a Monkey record as a band so that we can do what we do.
And so you've had a couple different lineups with Monkey68, but it seems like you've sort of solidified with this group.
Yes.
What do these guys bring to the table?
So I've been very blessed to play with great musicians all the way through Monkey68 over here and back in the UK, my bands that I was in the UK. But I've had a fabulous turnover of drummers. One after the other has come and gone because people have moved in the country and everything. So Patrick, then Tony, and now Trevor's in the seat, and I couldn't be happier with how it's balancing as a band, these two together as us as a three piece. It's just joyous. We just make like monkey music. It's kind of cool. So what they bring is Trevor is incredibly solid on the drums, and the drums are an instrument in the way he plays them, not just keeping a beat, which keys allows us to key off things. Craig and I, Craig is just fabulous in the bass, just as a unit with Trevor, and then I just get to play my stuff and just enjoy myself and not have to worry about what's going on elsewhere because these guys have got it tight, which is kind of cool.
So Vince is one of the most creatively prolific people I know, and if you're not familiar with all his work, you should go to vincet.net and check it out. So in addition to the music, we've got poetry,
yeah, books,
you've written a bunch of novels, and so I wondered, I mean, is there a crossover between the you're writing a long form novel versus writing a song? Do some of the same skills and methods come into play, or is it really like two different parts of your brain?
There's definitely themes that are similar, but the process is very different. Writing long form is meditative. You have to disappear for a long time, which is fun in one way but terrifying in others because you're actually not present, which is when you live in other people's characters and when you write books, it's kind of weird to be those people sometimes, especially if they're not very nice. In songs, it's more like poetry, you're just distilling it all down to the essence. And then you get to the state with the band where it's more about the groove and how you do it. So they are different but connected. I can't not do all of them together. So.
And there's one other kind of writing that you do, which is writing code. So in addition to the prolific songwriting and poetry, you've authored a couple of iPhone apps.
Yes.
And so at first to me, that seems like two just vastly different things. But I mean, I guess there is sort of a science to music and there is a creativity to programming.
Yeah, it's all problem solving. It, in one way, it's all just, it's all creative. So especially with code, if you're not just doing it as a sole service, so I'm doing it creating things from scratch, it's something that wasn't there before, and then you just set yourself a challenge. I wonder if I could do that, and then sure enough you get to the other end, like a novel. I wonder if I could do that. And that's when I coach people, which is my professional life. That's my main question, is what do you want to get done? Let's do it. I wonder what you could do, rather than all of it. And I mean, Dave's out in the audience, there's a few singer-songwriters, musicians in the audience for Common Ground. The moment you believe in a barrier is the moment you don't get stuff done. The moment you believe that the barrier isn't there or is permeable and you can get through it and there's something worthwhile on the other side of the barrier, that's the moment things come alive. So with the band, we literally practice every other week and we'll turn up and do a jam and it turns into a song, and I'm of the mind, let's perform it next practice. And these guys go with me, or let's perform it next gig. Whereas most bands will sit and finesse it and be scared about doing it. I'm just like, get it out there, just let's go. So it's all about fear, really. If you can give away the fear of creativity, then it's all good. Whether it's apps or music or writing or drawing or singing from the rooftops, it's all good.
So you mentioned another solo album possibly in the works, hopefully a group, band EP. Is the Common Ground open mic, that's still going on?
Still going on, 4 years strong. We're coming up on the fourth anniversary. We actually missed last night. There was some electrical work being done, so we actually had a night off, which is good for my voice, so that's kind of nice. I can sing today, but yeah, we're still going strong every Wednesday night, 7 till 11, upstairs at the Buckley, and yeah, it's good little community. Real.
All right, well, before you guys need to mop any more sweat off the brow, we should get back to it. This is Monkey 68.
It's warm up here. Thanks, Ben. Thanks for listening, everyone. So. Thank you.
It's a silver screen. This head upon my shoulders, putting things in order and counting out the frames of a movie in slow-mo. I got to chase a train wreck, tie me to the rail tracks. Thank you. just love. All it takes is one step and then a miss. To the beat of the rhythm in your chest. Your knees shake, let your heart break open.
Happy to see one person dancing. Feel free to tap your feet at least to this one, right? So keep dancing. Oh, that is great. Yeah, thank you very much for dancing. Wonderful.
I've seen you walking around here, and I've seen you hang around some other guy. Now tell me, what's your excuse? Between me and him, got to choose. Did you think it was easy trading me in? All I know is you got to feel the truth. We are him. We are him. It's me or him. I've seen you walking around here tonight. I've seen you hang around some other guy. Now tell me, what's your excuse? It's when it comes between me and him, you've got to choose. Baby, you've got to choose. Just choose. Just choose, just choose.
Thank you so very much. I'm going to chill things out for a little minute. Maybe because Trevor needs to stop sweating for a little while. This was on Sparse, and I played this a few years ago at the Wayne Awards, so it feels right to play it again. As a tree
But you just keep talking. Just to fit the space you are in.
So very much, thank you. We've got a couple more, maybe time for just a couple more. We're gonna bring things up. This is a British song, a very British song from 1997. Imagine the peak of Britpop, Oasis are doing their thing, Blur are doing their thing. And in the middle of it, this band called Grove in the UK are trying to do their thing, but it's kind of hard because there's not very many places to play. But now we get to play Hygienic Art Park as Monkey68.
Comes to me, I let it down. cause I deny it all. Got a cold heart, cause I won't let her through. To this cold heart. We're at stalemate, no makes a move. Could be checkmate, we would hate to lose. We stay bad mates, dance into the groove. Of a heartbeat. I turn a blind eye because it's easier that way. Turn a blind eye because there's something in the way. Something in the way that she's still here. And I'm still here. I turn a blind eye.
This will be the last song. I'm going to alter the lyrics because there's some kids in the art park. Thank you so much for coming out on a very hot day. Thank goodness for summer, that's what I say. This is a song called Walking Away. This is about the environment, believe it or not. It's not often I do things like that, but this one is.
When you're walking away, probably someone. walking away. When you're walking away.
At Hygienic Art for hosting us, and we will see you in the future. Thank you very much, guys.